charge for being right.
The Empire
is on the run.
We'll
be back with Kevin Booth,
Alex Jones, and the GCN Radio Network.
Every year we make resolutions to lose weight and get in shape. And the truth is, it's hard, even with diet and exercise, because of toxic food and our environment that is stressing our bodies more than ever before. Working with experts in nutrition and biochemistry, I found that super high-quality nutraceuticals, in addition to my diet and exercise, were the answers that synergistically worked. I can see the drastic changes every day with the amount of weight I've lost, my increased stamina, and more of a twinkle in my eye. That's why we are now so excited to launch the InfoWars Life Resolution Pack, combining three essential formulations: oxygen-based cleanser oxy powder, the secret 12 bioavailable vitamin B12, and your choice of super female or super male vitality. Now all available at a discounted price to you and your family to bring in the new year and make 2015 a true success. That's InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. 2015 is the year to do it, and it all starts at InfoWarsLife.com. For all of recorded history, civilizations around the world praised the health benefits of silver. At InfoWars Life, our mission is to bring you the highest quality, purest, cleanest, effective colloidal silver on the market today for the lowest price available. You don't have to be a doctor to know the fall and winter months are the most dangerous time of year in North America when it comes to you and your family's health. InfoWarsLife.com is very excited to announce our biggest run yet of Silver Bullet colloidal silver, exclusively available at InfoWarsLife.com. Now, InfoWarsLife.com has taken colloidal silver to the next level using a cutting-edge technique that is free of toxic artificial additives. Now more than ever, it's important to stock up on high-quality silver bullet from InfoWarsLife.com and to help others during Christmas by teaching them about the powerful benefits of silver. Secure your silver bullet today at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
Another major health threat, this one in Toledo, Ohio, where everybody in the entire city has been told not to drink the water.
Ohio's governor declaring a state of emergency.
Did you know that the average person uses about 80 to 100 gallons of water at home every single day? If there's a water emergency, will you be prepared?
Panicked residents forming long lines throughout the day.
We're here at a supermarket in Toledo. You can see the shelves empty where water once was.
To stay safe and healthy during a crisis, you must have access to safe, clean water. Water which will not be available at your local grocery store.
There's a mad dash on right now to stock up on supplies.
The ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system is a must-have for every modern, independently minded household. Protect your family's safety during an emergency. Go to InfoWarsStore.com today to purchase your ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system or call 1-888-253-3139.
I'll show you politics in America. Here it is, right here. I think the puppet on the right shares my beliefs. I think the puppet on the left is more to my liking. Hey, wait a minute. There's one guy holding up both puppets. Shut up.
Go back to bed, America. Your government is in control.
Defending the Republic from enemies, foreign and domestic, it's Alex Jones.
You know, I really shouldn't joke around about Bill Hicks because I've talked to some of his family before and they are mightily offended by people saying that I am Bill Hicks. A, our politics differed a lot, though he didn't trust the government. And he died, I guess, back in 93 or 94. I forget, Kevin, you can give us the details. But because you live in or lived in Austin, Texas, and I knew you from TV production stuff, and we did some work together. You've worked with hundreds of people, including HBO, Showtime, Tommy Chong. Maybe Tommy Chong is actually Bill Hicks. You've worked some with some of Russell Crowe's people, I guess. Russell Crowe must be Bill Hicks. I know he's thinking about making a Bill Hicks movie. This is where it really gets crazy. But now Texas Monthly's investigating. They have national news stories. Is Alex Jones Bill Hicks? As a joke, making fun of me. Like, I'm now getting conspiracy theories back on me. I never did conspiracy theories like that.
Yeah.
Well, Bill Hicks, you know, didn't like Waco being burned down, and Alex didn't either, so he must be Bill Hicks. Well, most Americans didn't like Waco. Kevin, let's just come clean. I am actually a cross-species clone between, well, John Wayne and Elvis.
That's right.
They're onto something, but I have lived before, but I was John Wayne and Elvis, not Doesn't matter that both men died after I was born. I am actually John. Well, you don't have to be dead to make a clone, I guess.
Well, maybe we're all being treated for schizophrenia right now by the government.
All right, I'm going to give you the floor before I run over you. Kevin, you're actually here to talk about a secret project you're working on.
I'm talking about a condominium for penguins.
Oh, yeah, that story. Seriously, the penguins are seeking shelter in the Antarctic because it's so freaking warm.
Well, that's why they got to get all those carbon taxes.
You know, that will fix. Well, California started it. They're starting it this week. You're going to have an added tax that literally goes to it's called Gore and Blood, not Blood and Gore. It's a carbon company. That's one of the companies. They're going to pay money. Just here's money to Al Gore and a British company. That'll save the earth, right, Kevin?
Well, as long as they build condos for... What about the pelicans? Little pelicans.
Fly a pelican?
Oh, pelican go.
Seriously, how do you like that?
Well, I guess I should be happy because the price of gas is so great, but...
Well, that's why they're doing it now. They're sneaking it all in when it's low.
Exactly. Just in time for me to buy a Prius.
How are you going to like it then when they jack up prices later?
Then I'm going to get my battery car that runs on coal. I'm just going to fill the back.
That actually uses more carbon than the other one. I know the old people have electric cars. They look down on you. And then the regular car that gets good gas mileage is better than their car.
Yeah, that's true.
I think Volts look great, but I'm tired of like yuppies looking down at me that I have a truck when their Volt uses more carbon than I do.
Well, and it only goes 30 miles before it runs on gas anyway.
They're good looking cars. I would buy a Volt if it had a V10 under the hood.
Teslas are cool.
Just as a you know what to Al Gore, a middle finger. I'm thinking about getting a Hellcat. 707 horsepower.
How about a nice Hummer or a tank?
Already got a big, I already drive a Ford Raptor.
Is that, I saw it out there. Is that you?
Yeah, I love it.
Nice.
I had it. Now everybody's got them and I don't care because I'm not like, oh, everybody has it. I don't care. When I got it like 3.5 years ago, nobody had them.
Did you get rid of the Dodge?
Yes.
You got rid of the Dodge?
Well, I had it like 7 years. It was a great car, but it, you know, I sped too much in it. The car went 200.
I miss Alex here. I haven't been to Austin. This is my first time to be in Austin in years. This is nice being back here.
Out at your dad's old ranch?
Yeah, back at the old ranch in Fredericksburg.
Where Bill Hicks had so many good times?
Yep. We used to trip all the time and had all our experiences back during the day.
No, it really is insulting to Bill Hicks for people to try to steal his identity and project it onto me.
It's strange. You know, my brother was schizophrenic. He was 9 years older, and he had a thing where he would project people's personalities onto other people. In fact, he thought he was this other guy for many, many years. And so after Bill passed away, and people used to say, Alex looks just like Bill, I would think, I don't think Alex looks anything like Bill. And I think it was just talk from that started some guy. I got a guy on my Facebook page claiming he's the one that started the conspiracy, and then we joked about it a few times and took off from there.
Well, I mean, he was from Texas, and he looked like a second cousin.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just crazy. I've had people 3 or 4 times come to me, like in restaurants, the street, go, Bill, Bill. And I don't respond. They go, oh, I was just checking. Like, I'm going to turn around when they say Bill.
Well, I mean, I get crazy people on the internet making these videos, but when Texas Monthly then puts it out there, and they actually choose the craziest of all the videos to promote. And if you go, I don't know if you've looked at some of the other videos that those people made, but they can also speak to dead babies, and they have a lot of other magical powers. Have you seen that?
I don't have time.
Yeah. I did a little research on the people that made the video. So...
Let's not show too much of it, folks. It's just ridiculous because they're so nuts. They'll claim copyright on videos claiming I'm Bill Hicks. I'm not even allowed to defend myself. Seriously, though, I am the son of John Wayne.
Yeah.
That'd be cool.
Yeah.
No, my dad's
Texan.
Cool.
You're all into the whole Texas thing, right?
Yeah, I'm not from Ohio like John Wayne, but...
You fought for the Texas Republic, right?
I did have ancestors. Enough about me. Actually, I am Davy Crockett reincarnated. Yes. Now we're... The New York Times probably run with that. I'm joking. This is satire, folks.
Am I Tony Montana?
How many times have we watched Scarface? I mean, you and I probably watched it 5 times together.
Yeah.
And how many times have you watched it?
500. No, when I was editing American Drug War, I just had it on a loop. That's great.
That was a very successful documentary you made. It's aired all over the place.
Yeah, it's did pretty well. It's still clocking numbers out there somehow.
It airs all over the world.
Yeah, did pretty good. And I think it's launched a lot of, I've seen a lot of other documentaries. I used to get offended when people steal your ideas, but I think just like music or anything else, when you see other documentaries coming out and they're using the same exact ideas and everything like that, it's pretty
well, I consulted on it, and then I got too busy to come out to L.A. to finish it with you. I'm really bummed that I didn't come finish the film with you, just like Russo wanted me in his Freedom to Fascism, and I was just too busy.
Yeah.
I should have done that.
Oh, well.
That's why I'm here today, to be in your film.
That's right.
Your secret film.
Yeah, we're working on a new top secret film. It has to do with how the history of the world has been molded by rigged elections and staged elections. But this time, we're actually going to be going over to the former Soviet Union and spending some time over in Bulgaria and some other places over there, where we have a new headquarters and some inside ways to get some footage and interviews and stuff that I never would have been able to get before. We got kind of a new stronghold over there and a whole situation where we've got security detail and the whole bit. It's going to be pretty cool.
It sounds like you were doing Vice-type stuff 10 years before they existed.
Yeah.
Going into dangerous third world countries, going into Skid Row, going into talking to the drug dealers. And so I guess you're going back to your roots. This is pretty exciting. Investigating dictatorships is not a very safe thing, though.
I know. But
I'm glad we're sending you to the front. I'll stay here. In the rear with the gear.
I went to Juarez for like 4 hours. Got in and got out real fast.
No, but you went into actually to the drug areas and stuff. You've done a bunch of that.
Yeah, no, it's gonna be serious. I mean, this story has been told before, obviously, by you several times, but hopefully what's gonna be different this time is that we're gonna be able to go into, like I said, former Soviet Union and tell it from that perspective. So it's gonna be an American perspective told from a Russian story.
But none of that matters. The drug war doesn't matter. What oligarchs are doing don't matter. It's just you are actually Jim Morrison. I'm going to start that here today, that you staged your death at 28 in Paris, or was it 27, and you are Jim Morrison. Jim, how did you come out with those first few albums? You're just a genius. I've always been such a fan of you since I was a little kid listening to your music.
We were just looking to open the doors of perception.
Now, did you get that from Huxley, Mr. Morrison? That's a Huxley statement, yeah.
That one, Doors of Perception.
I know Jim Morrison talked about the Doors of Perception.
Yeah. You know, my brother actually got hit over the head with a Coke bottle at a Doors concert. So I was actually in Los Angeles during that whole...
You knocked your brother over the head? Jim Morrison's brother?
I got another funny story from that day. I actually, when I was a little kid, I rode my bike to where the Manson Ranch was, out on the side of L.A.
When that was going on?
Yeah, when that was going on, actually. Some crazy, you know, it's kind of like a...
Maybe you're the son of Charlie Manson.
That could be. From who was the guy from the Beach Boys? Trey and I, we had an idea for a restaurant in Hollywood. We want to call it The Last Supper, where we have all the whole menu is all the famous Last Suppers from everybody. We want to have like the Sharon Tate meal and
Sharon Tate was so gorgeous, man.
Yeah.
What a crime to gut her.
Yeah. We just went to that property the other day and they changed the address. They bulldozed down the house and they changed the address by one number.
See, I'm really against war because it chews up women.
Yeah.
You go back to chivalry. You just leave the women alone. Take care of them. Hey, seriously. Again, my old buddy, Kevin Booth, I've known you since 1994 or so when I was first getting around Access 95.
Yeah.
Bill had just died. I had just staged my death.
Yeah, at the time, Bill was here in Austin working on several projects. We were actually working on a project that was called the Virtual Tonight Show for Australian TV, where we were going to do the thing about Branch Davidia. And
he was being offered national TV shows. He'd done one in England, all this stuff, but he'd rather stage his death and become Alex Jones.
Well, we had a thing where we were doing a gag where you remember the cows that were around the Branch Davidian compound?
Yes.
We were going to do a gag where Bill was going to be one of the cows that was out there by Branch Davidia, and he was like using that to get close to the compound. But during that whole time coming and going, you were just starting on public access TV, and you were this young guy that sat in front of the star map. And yeah, I couldn't really tell what you were rambling about, but it was kind of magnetic. And actually, Bill wrote a script about, it was called Public Access, where there was a main character kind of loosely based on you, named Arturo, that he was going to play. So he actually wrote a script, the main character.
There's the proof I became Alex Jones.
Yeah.
Well, you know, separately, I got to know and become good friends with Mike Judge. And I'd heard this from people that knew him, Rick Linkletter and stuff, because he produced the first Beavis and Buttheads. and then some of the King of the Hills out of the studios of Rick Linklater, Detour Films. It wasn't a Detour Films production. He just did it there. And I've been told by Linklater and Tommy Pilato that